from 6 to 7. A special remembrance is made in this Mass for Richard Hall and the people of the parish. Please stand. Our entrance hymn is number 618, I Sing in the Mighty Power of God, 618.
Thank you. you have promised to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our God and our Lord Jesus Christ. We ask
asked you, brothers and sisters, with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembling with him, not to be shaken out of your mind suddenly, or to be alarmed either by a spirit or by an oral statement or by a letter allegedly from us, to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He performed many miracles.
He heard that he was loving, compassionate, merciful, and all good things. So what is he going to do? Short as it was, he wanted to climb a tree and at least get a glimpse of Jesus. And he did exactly that. But Jesus, being the Son of God, certainly knew who Zacchaeus was. He knew all about him. And he knew that there was good in him, even though he was a sinner. And certainly the gossipers, as the gospel said, groaned. What's Jesus doing with such a sinner? A bad, bad person, they thought Zacchaeus to be, which he was. But there's always hope for everybody. People are tempted from the time they reach the state of reason. And many times people fall. They commit sin. They hurt others. They offend God. They hurt themselves. But remember, we have a God of love. A God who looks upon each one of us as soiled as we may be by evil. In retrospect, people look to the past and they have so many regrets. Maybe they lost a good marriage, they lost a good family, they lost good friends, simply because evil looked good to them. They were tempted. They wanted that illicit pleasure, which lasts for sometimes a matter of minutes, if that. And sometimes that pleasure lingers on, and then it hits them like a ton of bricks. And hurt, and grief, and regrets. We don't know if Zacchaeus was ever declared a saint. Maybe he was. He came to Jesus and told him, I'm going to make up for all the evil I caused, and so I'm going to give to the poor. If I cheated anyone, I'm going to return what I cheated four times over. And so, you might say he was a saint. You might say he was cleansed of sin because he met Jesus. Most Christians do know who Jesus Christ is. They do know what their relationship with Jesus should be. And yet, for one reason or another, they ignore him. They turn their back on him. They're even tempted to say, I don't owe my allegiance to him. I have free will, and I'm going to do what I so wish to do, regardless of who gets hurt. But at least this story, this gospel, has a happy ending. Jesus does come to his home. Zacchaeus does repent, and hopefully, upon his demise, he enters the kingdom of God. And so be it for all of us as well. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe one of God.
for us and for our salvation. We thank God for that. But
the Holy Spirit was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, it is crucified by the Father's Father.
Again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the
Lord, the divine life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess for baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of all time. Amen.
Trusting in God's love and care for us, let us bring our prayers before Him.
For all members of the Church, may God grant us open hearts to welcome the lost and receive them with love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For public officials, may God grant them courage in working for the common good rather than personal gain. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those nearing the end of life, may God send His peace and enable them to receive His love through those who support them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may Jesus open our hearts to see others as God sees them, and to love without judgment or criticism. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world and its people, may God in His mercy bring an end to violence that plagues us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the faithful departed, especially Jane Purvis and John Beecher, may they, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-loving God, we thank You for always hearing our prayers. We ask You to answer them according to Your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 460, Jesus Shall Reign, 460.
Oh,
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Elizabeth of Hungary, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
communion hymn is number 793, One Bread, One Body, 793.
Oh,
Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God be with you.
We humbly pray.
And in God, the presence of the heavenly host.
By the power of God, cast us into
all
Satan
and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our recessional hymn is number 585, Praise to the Lord, 585.